You can also animate text. Let's animate this list on slide 2. Just select the text box and then click the drop-down menu in the animations group. This menu looks a little bit different than the menu we saw when we first applied an animation effect to the picture on the slide. That is because PowerPoint gives you different animation options based on the object that is selected. Since we are working with a list, we have the option to have the text appear all at once or appear by first level paragraphs. And we can have it fade in, wipe in, fly in, or apply a custom animation. Let's try our two fade options. I'll select fade all at once. And you can see that the image appears and then the text appears all at once. This whole block of text is assigned to the number 1. If I click the drop-down arrow to expand the contents in the task pane, I can also see that the 3 bullets are grouped together into one action, so they will appear at the same time. If I select fade by first level paragraphs, the text will now appear bullet by bullet. Each bullet is assigned a different number, 1, 2, and 3, on the slide. If I click the drop-down arrow to expand the contents in the task pane, I can also see that the 3 bullets are labeled, so they will appear consecutively in the slideshow. The animations that are available from the menu are usually sufficient, but if you want to have more control over how you animate objects, you can make changes right here in the custom animation task pane. For example, if I select 1, I can modify the way the text starts or appears and the speed. I can also click the drop-down arrow associated with the objects, which in this case is our first bullet of text. From this menu, I can modify it so the text appears on the click with the previous action or after the previous action. I'll just leave this as it is. If I select Effects Options or Timing, a dialog box will appear where I can really fine-tune the effect. On the Effects tab, I can add enhancements such as sounds, and I can decide what happens to the object after the animation. I can hide the text after the animation or when the next object appears. I can even change the color of the text after the animation. Since I am animating text, I can choose to have it appear all at once, word by word, or letter by letter. On the Timing and Text Animation tab, you can really fine-tune the animation. There is so much you can do here that I'll let you explore that one on your own. Let's press Slideshow and see how this slide looks. I like the way this looks, but I'd like the picture to appear last. To reorder any of the animations, just select the animation you want to move, and then use the arrows at the bottom of the task pane to reorder. Now press Slideshow so we can see how this works. There, that looks good. Before we wrap up talking about animations, let me animate slide 1 and show you how the animation can work with sound. I'd like to animate the star, so I'll select it. I could apply one of these animation effects, but I'd like to add a custom animation. I'm just going to make sure the star object is selected, click Add Effect, and then choose an emphasis effect. The default settings for the spin effects are for it to occur on the click, turn clockwise 360 degrees at a medium speed. I'll just change that to 2 spins and leave the rest as the defaults. I can see that my sound file appears in the custom animation task pane, and it is labeled with the number 0. Right now, the music is set to start after previous, which means it will start when the slide appears, and the star will begin to spin when I click. You can click play or slideshow to confirm that this is what will happen. I can change that by selecting the star in the custom animation task pane and changing the animation so it will begin with the previous. This means the star will spin as the music starts playing. You can always click play to see how it will work. There, that looks good. You can do so many things with animation. On charts, you can set the chart information so that it appears by series, category, or element in a series or category. You can animate parts of a table and any shapes. The key with animation is think about what makes sense. Don't add animation just to add animation. On a slide with a lot of information, carefully animated text may make the slide easier to read. And with diagrams and charts, animation may make the data easier to understand. Just be careful and don't use too much animation. Have some fun exploring all the animation options PowerPoint has to offer.